Hi, welcome back to another video. Today we are playing Mercenary Zaga Chronicles. And this game came out on the eShop today. It's like three games in one. Two of these games came out on the 3DS eShop, which is the second and third one. But the first one I don't believe was ever translated over to English, but it's been included in this Chronicle Zaga thing, you know, where they're all combined together. It's only like 15 euro on the eShop, which is really good. And this game is supposed to be like Final Fantasy Tactics and that type of style, which is really interesting. Because I really like Final Fantasy Tactics. I have not played a game like that in a long time, though. So I'm going to be pretty rusty, but I really love games that style, so I'm very excited to try it out. We're just going to stay with the first game today and see how it goes. Mercenary Zaga is World of White Lions. Also, they even have like a separate page for this. How to play, options, all that good stuff. I don't know if I want to read this right now. We're just gonna see how it goes once we begin. New game. Oh, different difficulties. Enemies turn easy. Equip change in battle possible. HP recovery after level up due. And from KO to retreat 8 turns. And normal equip change. Okay, HP does not recover after level up. And from KO to retreat 5 turns. Back to easy if it seems too difficult for me, but normal right now. Afornia, the green continent, known for its vast expanses and warm climate, the Flare Kingdom stretched from the south to the west, as several small countries occupied the southeast and the north. Amongst the smaller countries was the historical Mondoa Kingdom at the southern tip. The current ruler is King Mondoa the 12th. Snowy white peaks and shiny blue seas have protected them from invasions for centuries. But in recent years, the Flare Kingdom has become imperialistic, conquering other smaller countries. Fearing their impending doom, Mondoa declared war on the small country of Sekrak, to the north in a show of might. Though Mondoa had the upper hand, Sekrak's fierce resistance prolonged the war. The situation brings great joy to those who fight for coin, the mercenaries. Many bands of mercenaries fight on the numerous front lines. Blah, blah, blah. There's so much. I'm like watching the text fly by. And then I'm trying to read it at the same time and it distracts me. Many bands of mercenaries fight on the numerous front line conflicts in order to amass a fortune. But that is the story of the big name, well-established groups. Our story differs in many ways, focusing on the young commander Leon and his troops of but six fresh-faced mercenaries, the White Lions. Oh look, we have the crew here. This place looks really cute. Oh, it's you, Leon. How goes it? Not too bad, I guess. More importantly, have any requests come in? Preferably the quick and easy kind. Come now, I would have done them myself if they had. True enough. All we have now is, let's see. What do you say to capturing Zanon Castle? The front lines bring the most cash. Are you so drunk you're seeing double? Give me something a band of our size can accomplish. That was merely in jest. How about some bandits? They're a small group, so it will be for a little coin, but it's an easy enough job. A bit of bandit killing, eh? Easy enough, Commander. Claudia, what do you think? We'll be fine against Yabba without Miriam and Ronel. I believe so, too. There you have it, friend. We'll take their quest. Right, good luck out there. Looks like he has some nice food behind the counter, and I kind of want it. The reports say the bandits are spotted around here. Yeah, that's right. Our targets here are the Grundax, a small but rising bandit group. They line along this here Belko Highway to attack travelers and traders. They may be small, but Miri and Ronel are gone on a separate request. Well, less backup than usual, so make sure you don't forget it. Aye, aye, sir. I'll work hard to cover for Miri's absence. But please don't overwork yourselves, everyone. Of course, Julia, we're relying on your support. Come on, Julia, the enemies are in sight. Hold it right there! If you value your lives, put down your valuables and scram. Are you the Grundax terrorizing this place? You don't look like soldiers to me, what are ye? I wouldn't normally dirty your names by telling it to the likes of you. But I'll make an exception. We are the White Lion Mercenaries. Surrender now give our guests a warm welcome. Yes, sir. So much for negotiating. Get ready, everyone. Can you really call a negotiating commander? Alright, it's our first battle. Oh, there's some treasure chests on the field. I want to go pick those up, too. Alright, so Leon is a fighter. Claudia's an archer. You're a fighter. And you're a non-slow healer. Alright, interesting. Let's see. Who do I want to put where on the field? Well, I guess we should probably put Leon, like, at the front of the party. Let's put Leon, like, right here. You can face this way. That's probably the best way to put you there because you're facing that direction and you can probably handle a good few attacks. And also on the front lines, I'm gonna put Muller because he looks like a strong guy too. He's got pretty high defense. So he can face outwards this way. There is one bandit guy up here, which you need to deal with. So I'm gonna put Claudia on this side because I think she can handle it pretty easily. And I'll put Julia behind you for support. Have you a tutorial? I guess I will. Oh man, looks like they got a lot of stuff here. I don't know if I want to read all this. Let's see. Additional effects. Additional effects can occur depending on enemy and ally positioning. When additional effects occur, they will have an effect on attack, defense, or evasion. For example, attacking an enemy from behind its side will... Oh yeah, I know that much. Attacking from a higher position than an enemy will deal additional damage. On the other hand, attacking from a lower position will decrease damage dealt. Charging an enemy with allies will also deal additional damage. Your defense will increase when allies surround you as well. Pay damage using the forecast window shown while attacking. What's aggro? Okay, the aggro value shows how likely the enemy is to target that unit. Higher it is, the more likely they are to be targeted. Attacking enemies or healing allies cause these values to rise. Pressing plus or minus, you can display a unit's aggro on their HP bar. Okay, pressing that will once again hide the aggro value. And I might as well check this too. Attack, approach enemies and attack shield damage. Oh wait, won't counterattack if you're outside your weapon range. So if you're in the range, they'll counterattack. For example, Leon's greatsword is capable of attacking in a diagonal. Enemies won't be able to counterattack unless they also have a greatsword or long-range bow. Likewise, Leon's throwstone skill can be used to attack from a distance, although its damage is relatively low. Alright. A character's equipped with a shield can defend instead of wait. Damage received will be halved while defend is active. Healing characters are unable to continue fighting if they run out of HP. To prevent this, use an item or skill to recover their HP. Alright, MP. Oh wait, defend or wait guarantees more MP than other actions. Alright, so yeah, I don't think I need to go into too much detail here. I have a general idea. Additional information regarding battles can be viewed later from the X button menu. Alright, cool. Alright, let's just start. Alright, we can only move so far right now. Let's see, you're gonna need to be closer to attack, so I'm gonna move you up here. You can face... And you can just face straight up. Can I use a skill with you, poison shot? I can't hit anyone from here though. I'm too far away. I doubt I can hit the treasure chest from here, can I? Nope! Alright, I'm too far away to do much, so I'm gonna probably just have to wait this turn out, unfortunately. How far can the rest of y'all move? Well, you can't move very far. It looks like you're gonna be waiting a turn. I guess I can move you to... let's see, maybe... Floor 18 on the map. Where's the space they're letting me move into? Alright, there's the space. You can face out this way. Maybe you can throw a stone or something. Wait, no, it's not you that can throw the stone. It was somebody else. Well, you also have first aid, so you have a healing skill of sorts as well. And I guess you can wait it out here this turn. And you can try and move a little closer. I'm gonna move out here, because then I'm still a little bit out of the way, I think. So they can't hit me too much. I feel like this is a good position to be in. Well, there's an edge there. Okay, you can throw the stone, alright. shut us down. Well, you know what? If I move you over in a different area, like right here, I think you might be able to show a stone at least. Let's see if I can show a stone right from here. Yeah, just about. Okay, there's a treasure chest, but I'll pick that up next turn, maybe. Okay, so 100% and we'll do... Is that just fire damage? Only 4, well, it's better than nothing, I suppose. And what are your skills? Okay, yeah, you just mostly heal and protect. Maybe I should raise people's defenses as a start. Let's raise the dude at the front of our party's defense. I feel like that's probably a good way to start off. Alright, skill. Alright, he's kind of leading the attack, so we'll use Protect on him to give him a little support. Alright, so now his defense is up. Now it's the enemy phase. What are they gonna do? Oh man, she can still throw a stone from that distance. A couple of these guys are moving forward. They're coming after me. They brought some, have some head-on-head battle right here. Well, 20 damage. Good thing I raised his defense, because that guy seems to do pretty decent damage. Oh, you know, maybe I should try to take care of this dude over here. I'm pretty fast. Throw stone. Maybe I should try to use feint as well. He used that on me. So I feel like I could use it on him right back. I do 18. He's gonna counterattack, but I still do a good bit of damage, so I'm gonna go for it. I did 17 damage. You got 9 damage done on me, though. I'm gonna need to be careful. Oh, wait. Can I still move you? Oh, man. If I moved him, maybe I could have this guy come in for an extra attack. But you can move closer, at least. And let's see. Do any of your skills work here? What about rapid attack? Can you use that? No, he needs to be like directly in front of you. I should have put you in a better position. I guess you can wait here. And you can heal. Oh, we got a couple items actually, but all of a sudden you use your regular healing skill. He's gonna need a little bit of healing. I wanna make sure he stays healthy right there. And then my archer might be able to go in and do some damage on this one now. Oh, wait, let me check my skills. A chariot shot. Let's use this on her. Actually, I should try to get up to higher ground because then I can do more damage. Yeah, I'll go right beside the chest so I can do more damage from up here. And I'll face outwards. Facing towards her. And I can use poison shot too. I'm just gonna use this one though. I'll do 34 damage. Sweet! That's quite a bit. Unfortunately, that means now she can come up to my level and attack me too. Only for 2 damage, though, and I did hit her right back afterwards, which is good. I want to make sure I get the treasure chest in this battle too. I'm worried that I won't get them. Well, he's attacking me head on, but I'm countering with a 7. I feel like I'm playing a game of cards when I say, like, I countered with a 7. I countered with, like, the 7 of clubs or something. I don't know. Makes me feel like I'm playing a card game slightly. Alright, so... I think I'll finish you off this turn. And then I'll try to open the chest. 73 gold, awesome! And then down here... Wait, what's that hate point? So what's hate supposed to mean? What's that supposed to mean? Alright, let's move you forward a little bit. You can deal with the guy back here. Still need to pick up these treasure chests, but I'll try and take this guy out or do at least a good bit of damage to him. I'll do 26 damage. That's pretty good. Now he's down to half HP. And maybe if you... Oh, you should attack from the side, actually. You can do more damage that way. So you sneak up here. Face this guy right in the face and show him that he's not gonna survive, basically. 21. Oh, we might not kill him, hopefully. Oh, it's close. Oh, should I have my mage finish it off? I don't know. Is this a good idea? She could finish it, though. just a healer. She does whatever she wants. I think if I move a bit away, I should be able to open this treasure chest. Hey, I'm Skinna. Wait, do I have to use a special skill? Can I not just... if I move just like a little bit away, like here, can I use like just a regular attack? No, I seem to have to use a special skill. I guess I'll use Chariot Shot then. Can't do it from that position though. I'm gonna have to move away a little bit. Alright, you're gonna have to use Chariot Shot to open this treasure chest. So it seems like a waste of MP, but oh well. Why is it not letting me hit it? Wait, let me see if I can hit the treasure chest over here. Or if I just get them after battle. Like, what happens if I just try to bust this treasure chest open? Can't seem to do that, actually. Oh, okay, I guess I can't just bust the treasure chest open. I thought I could. But I've been mistaken. I guess not as easy as that to open these treasure chests. Oh, that's a shame. I wanted to open them. Like, right away. Let's see if I have you come up a little closer. Can you open this one? Can I throw a stone at the treasure chest? No, I can't seem to... Wait. Oh, wait. Maybe I'm supposed to use a different button. Oh, wait. Maybe I'm supposed to use the investigate button. That's it, isn't it? Oops. That's just me being silly. I should have used the investigate button, maybe. Wait, but you can't seem to investigate. Oh, wait, now you can investigate. Ah, okay, there we go. I was confused. I was very confused. Alright, that explains a lot more. I'm gonna have you move forward a little bit. I need you to be careful, though, since you are the healer. I feel like you'll take a lot more damage than these guys. But you can heal Leon. Healing. I'm trying to bring her closer to the treasure chest, so she can pick it up next turn. Alright, you can go right here, face the treasure chest. You're gonna have your behind open though, so you're gonna wanna watch yourself. But at least you got a heal potion. What do you think you're doing? Oh, he didn't actually hit me from the back, he hit me from the side. I feel like it could have been a better idea to hit me from the back, but I guess whatever he wants to do, right? You're still far away from the treasure chest, but I'll slowly bring you over here. Oh, I can use defend from here. Let's do that. I need you to pick this up next turn, though. Or you guys can try to do a little bit of damage to weaken this guy down a tiny bit. What if I try rapid attack? How much does this do? Okay, 25. He has a good bit of HP, so I might as well start weakening him a bit. And he counters, not for too much though. Can I just regular attack on him? I want to make sure we don't die. I mean that he doesn't die before we open the treasure chest. So, let's end my turn right here. Let's see what he does. Okay, he's going for a rapid attack though. Hey, look at you all last round. I'm just letting you off because there's treasure. I really want to pick up. It's important to collect the goods after all. I must investigate. Oh, a soul stone. Not sure that doesn't sound interesting. Alright, now you guys can finish this off. Hit him with a 24. He's gonna get me back with a 6. I got leveled mid-battle. Yay! That's the thing in battle. Your characters kind of get experience from just whatever they do in battle. It's not like a overall after-battle thing. Like, it's not after battle that they give you an experience. You get experience for doing, like, the little actions in battle. Which I think's pretty cool. You know, actually, you can't really do anything. You're just gonna stay there. But you, on the other hand, you can finish this off. And 90 gold! Yay! Stage clear! Alright, we got some bonus. And that's one more request complete. Shh, be quiet! I know you're over there, come on out! Hey, you got me, lower your weapons, I won't fight! Nor will I run or hide. Pretty sure you were just hiding. Who are you, an ally of the Grundex? Now that's a toughie. I guess all depends on your point of view. What do you mean? And Cheetah was about to ask them to let me join. New band groups are short on members, so I figured I'd get in no problem. And that's when you all came along and started fighting them. I wasn't exactly gonna go help them since I hadn't joined up, so I just hid and watched from here. I see, you should count your lucky stars. Had you joined any sooner, you'd be on the ground right now, too. Hey, you're not wrong. It was a narrow escape. Without the coin to buy for food, I have just swapped death by sword to death by starvation. I've had a great idea. Let me ask you something, boss man. Well, what is it? Why don't you let me join your mercenary group? In the looks of things, you don't have many members. I'll be of use, I swear. Hey, look at you turning this into a sales pitch. Although we did command you, Leon. It's true, I was hoping to expand. Thanks to you, my plans have all been ruined. I won't tell you to take responsibility. How about doing me a favor? I guess I have no good reason to say no. See, it's a done deal then. My name is Bastion. Thanks for having me, boss man. Bastion joined the party. Yay! After each battle, you'll be taken to a screen where you can prepare for the next one. You can change character equipment and spend SP on skills. In addition, you can buy items from the shop and save or load the game. Start the next chapter, please select story. Alright, so now we can check. Oh, look, he's level 3, he's higher level than us! Oh man, he's even higher level! It feels bad, man. Alright, let's check out our characters and see what we can do. Alright, so we got our equipment. Oh, do we have anything else better to clip on anyone? I don't know if we do. Buckler? Oh, we picked up another buckler. Can someone else clip a buckler? Oh, but, let's see, does this work well for some of our characters? Yeah, we can clip a buckler on quite a few. Alright, I feel like you're the type of unit that should have a buckler, but I think I'll give you the buckler this time. I don't have much equipment to give out. Let's check skills. Oh, here are different skills. So we got 215 SP. And can I choose to spend this on whatever character I like? It looks like I can choose whoever I want to spend it on. And there's also a class tree, so if we reach level 10, we can make our class a higher level. Alright, that's pretty cool. Alright, this is pretty neat. I'm liking the looks of these menus. Alright, let's see, what will we increase? Who will we do some investing in? Let's see, what does this do? Min plus 2, do I get 3 extra min on the field if I use this? I'm not sure what that actually means. I'm guessing maybe something about the area of effect or something? Okay, you know, you didn't have too many skills. Maybe we can get you another skill. This will increase MP use, so you know what? Let's increase faint. Let's increase this. Oh, there's a strength increase. That would be a good passive to increase. I didn't even notice it. First aid's always useful. This throwing stone ability will probably be useful for a long time, so I'm gonna increase it by a bit. And yeah, I should have probably increased a couple more allies stuff, but I'll just do his for now. We'll get more points as we progress anyway. There's also a shop to visit. Let's check it out. Well, let's see, so there's different types of swords, weapons, let's see, I have 1,326 gold, that will be pretty good to buy. Oh, we don't have any members for certain equipment so far, but we can increase your attack power. I feel like I've been giving you a lot, though. I feel like I should give something to someone else right now if I'm to give something to anyone. Oh, and then you can also equip this shield. There's also... Oh, this is helpful for a new guy. Hey, let's buy one of these. And let's buy one buckler. Alright, we've also got some different armors right here that could be useful. Well, tunic's helpful for a magic character right there. And this leather armor is helpful for if you'll buy one of these. And we also got some feet. We got shoe problems. We're gonna want to invest in some better shoes. I'm running a bit low on money though, so I think I may pass. Oh, magic section. Oh, these add like a couple extra stats. Dexterity and intelligent points. There's also free battles and a story, of course, if we wanted to go do that. I got some new stuff to equip now, though, so I might as well do that. I got the buckler on you. That lowers some of your stuff, but it also raises things. Let's give you leather armor. And I think I was gonna give you something better. Wait, wasn't I gonna give you the leather armor? Hold up. I'll always my magical defense a little bit. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'll give it to this dude instead. Leather helmet, who wants it? Few people already have it. You're the only one that doesn't have it, so I guess I'll give it to you. Alright, so this looks like an interesting game. I am gonna end this video off here though, so thank you guys so much for watching. Let's check out the save menu to all lots of save files. I just wanna see how it looks. Okay, I was hoping they had like little face picture things, but they don't. Chapter 2, Evil. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys again in my next one. Bye-bye!